took me only 11 years to madly fall in love with 3D printing technologies. But from that moment, nothing, and I mean nothing, could stand between us. I gave up my position as a university professor to pursue this passion full time. And I've traveled around the world, setting up 3D printing labs, manufacturing lines, and even earning myself the rather flattering nickname, Father of 3D Printing, in one of those countries. This journey for me started in 2002, when I visited an exhibition at the Stadtgalerie in Stuttgart. The artist Karen Sander dared to do something remarkable. She used 3D printing to create her art. Visitors, including myself, could have their full body scanned, a miniature version of themselves created using these 3D printers. Fascinating. I remember taking one of those miniature objects, about 1 to 10 scale, and looking at these tiny humans that were birthed from the machine. For me, it was a visit to a lab in Cairo, Egypt in 2013 that generated my real aha moment. In that rather obscure lab, surrounded by 3D printers, as well as people working on diverse projects in the field of additive manufacturing, it occurred to me that this tool wasn't just a tool for art, but it was a tool for great change. 3D printing. What if I told you that within 7 days, that your dream home could be produced and ready for you to move in? It's not one of those pop-up tents from IKEA, which, by the way, takes about 7 days to set up. But rather, this phenomena, 3D printing, is unique. It is unique because at first it looks like science fiction, but it isn't science fiction. Let me take you on a journey which for me created the impression that with this tool, we could revolutionize how we tackle one of humanity's greatest challenges, the affordable housing crisis. But first, let me share some hard facts with us, facts that could make us pause for a moment. According to the United Nations, about 830 million people live in slums around the world. That's about twice the entire population of the European Union. It's alarming, but it even gets worse. It's estimated that about 2 billion people by the year 2030 will be moving into cities, and that's about a quarter of the entire world population. With that kind of data, when we start building homes, we'll need to be building at least 28 million homes every year. That's about 3,000 houses every hour for a decade. Think about how long it took your contractor to finish your bathroom, and then you get a sense of the urgency of the situation we have. Here in Germany, we have a housing deficit of about 800,000. In my home country, Nigeria, we have a housing deficit of about 28 million. 28 million people in search of homes over their heads. It's a lot. Now, the construction industry as we know it, with all its historical experiences, just isn't set up to manage a demand of the scale. To do that, we need to have something that could work faster, more efficiently, and affordably. And this is where 3D printing could provide a much greater impact on society. Take, for example, Tabasco, and I'm not referring to the hot sauce here. Tabasco in Mexico. In Tabasco, about 50 homes were produced using 3D printing technologies. And these homes, each of them, took about 48 hours to print. 48 hours. It is phenomenal. And the cost? Between $4,000 and $10,000. That is phenomenal. In fact, one of the residents of these homes noted that her first night in her 3D printed house was the first time she had slept in a real bed. We're not just building houses. The plan here is to build futures. Think about the ripple effect on families and communities and how we're able to lift people out of homelessness, one layer of concrete after the other. We've seen this technology do great things around the world. In Denmark, in Malawi, in Kenya, in the United States, in China, in India, and here in Germany. These printers are not just printing houses that are affordable. The houses are durable, they're customizable, and they're printed faster than ever before. In fact, the beauty of this is that 3D printing allows us to design these houses to the taste of the owner, of future owner of these houses. It is unbelievable. Well, the message here is that with this technology, we can solve and provide solutions to one of humanity's greatest challenges, the affordable house issue. 3D printing isn't just cool tech. It's a real scalable solution to the crisis we face today, our ability to print homes, one house after the other. I know what you're thinking. You're probably thinking that this is probably one of those 3D printed coffee mugs, looks cute, but breaks after a few uses. No, this is far from it. 3D printed houses are structurally sound. They are built with precision, designed to last for a very long time. Just imagine a situation where you can personalize your house with the same ease with which you customize your Spotify playlist. Think about it. Let me even push that envelope a bit further. What if we added artificial intelligence to this mix? Imagine a situation where, with a tap of a button, an AI tool creates a design based on your wildest dreams, pixel by pixel, layer by layer. It's unbelievable, but that is happening today. Imagine this being like putting a magic wand in the hands of an architect. It allows the architect to generate imaginable pieces of work within a very short time. And what does this mean for the environment? With 3D printing, we're not just printing to save time. We're printing to save resources. Traditional manufacturing methods or traditional construction methods are quite wasteful. The good thing about 3D printing is that you only use the amount of material which you need. It's like the Marie Kondo of building. You use everything and have no waste with it. And the carbon footprint is quite small. The on-site waste is almost non-existent. And what does this mean for labor? We're already used to the fact that when you come into a construction site, you have armies of workers. 3D printing is completely different. You only need three professionals to be able to execute any construction work: a materials handler, a printer controller, and a supervisor. Just imagine an entire street of houses being printed by a team you could count out of your hands. It's amazing, and we do see improvements in this technology. Imagine a case where an entire construction work could be executed by one person. It's a lot of savings. And so we have a tool that would allow us lift as many people as possible out of homelessness. A tool that promises the build of sustainable societies around the world. it is clear to me that as we look into the future, that the ideas that got us to where we are today aren't going to take us to the next big thing. For us to be able to confront and solve the challenges of our times, including the housing crisis, we need to think differently. We need to embrace new tools and new technologies. We need to reimagine construction. One pixel, one layer of concrete, and one house at a time. Are you ready for that future? Are you ready to embrace that future?
Yes.
One pixel, one layer of concrete, and one house at a time.